Hey guys, my friend here has bought the world's strongest coffee, and today we are going to try it. Let's get right into this. So, the coffee is called Defrish Coffee, and you want to say where you bought this, actually?
I bought it at Walmart.
Yeah.
In the coffee section. It's roughly $20.
$20 for 18 cups, which, if we take a little bit of a zoom. Hopefully it should, focus. Focus. Ah, there we go. Death Wish Coffee. Wonderful. Here, since it's already zoomed in, let's get a close up on the box. Test your strength. And now it actually says pretty funny stuff on the back. Now, why don't you, read what says on the back.
Okay, so it says Death Wish Coffee is created using the strongest possible combination of organic and fair trade beans and roasting them in small batches to perfection. Death Cups use the signature blend in a covalent, I can't say that word.
It's fine.
Single serve cup that's both strong and delicious. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some may say making coffee this strong is irresponsible. We like to think that it is revolutionary.
And we will be the judge of that. So we are going to go and make it, and we will be right back. With a snap of my finger, we will have the coffee on this table. See you in a little bit.
Whoa!
So guys, I know this is a pretty cringy video, so I'm gonna actually cut back on the cringe anymore. this is, actually does claim to be the world's strongest coffee, which since it claims to be, it kind of has to be, because then it would be false advertisement if it does. Now, it smells like normal coffee. And doing research, it was supposed to taste like chocolate and something. I already forgot what it was supposed to do. Maybe Ed the Sky can say what it was. But now this is, I don't really know how much of a video this could be. This is gonna be like a really short video, but hopefully this should be cold enough, because actually while we was filming the previous clip, this coffee was already made. It was just sitting by my computer.
You're supposed to tell them.
I don't think I was supposed to tell them that, but I just ruined the editing trick. The coffee was already made. I didn't go downstairs, make the coffee, and then come back upstairs. The coffee was already made.
But still hot.
Yeah. But hopefully not too hot.
We're gonna be trying this.
Yeah. That's the world's bitterest coffee in the world.
It's not so much of strong, it's more of bitter.
Oh, that's so bitter.
Takes another sip.
I mean, we don't have to drink all of it, so.
Yeah. I mean, if you add sugar, like, this is just plain coffee, so if you just if you add your normal stuff that you do to your regular coffee, I'm sure it'll be pretty good. Like sugar, milk, whatever you add.
But maybe this is not the one that I've seen online, but maybe this is just the plain version. Maybe there's different versions of them.
I don't know,
but it's not bad.
It's not too bad.
No, it's not that bad. Which, to be fair,
I've had worse.
Yeah, I think I'm actually starting to like bitter things a lot more.
Also, there's no water in it, really.
I'm used to Great Value coffee. So I'm used to like really watered down coffee. So this is not watered down at all. Now, I don't know what kind of, oh my goodness, okay. Yeah, it's definitely.
It gets worse as you get lower down in the cup.
I was actually very tired.
Shake it up.
But now I'm not tired at all.
Hey, the only coffee that actually wakes you up.
Hey, I don't have the shakes yet. And it's not... Okay, maybe... Okay, cold... Okay, The only coffee I drink lately is cold coffee. And it's already like pre-made coffee and stuff. I feel like I'm also talking really fast. Am I?
I don't know. I'm not really paying attention
to you. Okay, so the only type of coffee I normally drink is cold coffee, but coffee always upsets my stomach, but so far my stomach's not upset, so maybe
also,
maybe
cold. I think we kind of hyped it up more than what we were thinking. Like, we thought that it would be over. Like, I think we hyped it up more than what we should have.
Where coffee is last.
You're shaking now.
if you don't know, I love coffee.
Oh, have you seen in the bottom of your cup?
Hmm?
If you look real closely at the bottom of your cup,
yeah,
you can see the stuff floating around in it.
What stuff? I don't see anything.
Oh yeah, you finished yours. I'm not done.
So, I'm already done with my coffee. Let's now do the shake test. I still don't see like I'm...
I'm shaking.
Well, you always kind of shake.
I always kind of shake, yeah.
So, I do feel like I'm actually talking a little bit more than normal, and I oh my goodness. Normally, coffee has no effect on me.
Hold on.
I mean, normally coffee does have a little bit of effect on me, but that's not really because of the caffeine or anything. It's just because I really do love coffee.
Mm-hmm.
But
it's good taste. It's for the taste.
But since this is actually not really, I don't really like it for the test. This actually has this.
Does it say how many calories it has in it?
Wait, yeah, it must have.
Probably on the bottom.
Wait, does it have no facts on it? It has.
We're gonna die.
There's no facts on it.
All it says, world's strongest coffee.
It, ingredients, organic coffee. That's it. Also, if you can't tell, I shaved. Yeah.
I don't know what I was expecting going into this, but... It's not bad. I've had worse.
Yeah. Normally, I don't like bitter stuff. But to be fair, I haven't had normal coffee in so long. So I haven't had something bitter in like maybe a year or two.
You actually know what this reminds me of?
What?
Whenever I was up in Yellowstone and we took the wagon ride out there, and they made their own coffee from very scratch. Just out on a random campfire, they just started making old school coffee.
Like, wait, coffee on a campfire?
Yeah, they made cowboy coffee, which is really cool because they just put beans, they crush up the beans, put it in a sock, and put it in a pan, and they let it boil until it's done, I guess. And, like, it's some bitter stuff, but it's actually really good because, well, I guess it's just because it's, from scratch.
See, the whole thing about bitter things is the bitter, like, lasting, like, mouth, like, it feels like tens of minutes.
I don't know, mine's starting to cut down a little bit.
Like, well, that, it might be just because I have, like, taste bud problems, but, I don't really know what type of video I was expecting. I guess we did really hype this up. I mean, it's not like I was expecting us to be bouncing around the rock walls, but...
I don't know, I am shaking, though, more than I normally shake. I always shake, but I'm shaking a little
more.
I feel good. I feel like I can go on a run.
I was definitely tired before recording this, and I'm definitely really awake, and... My throat feels a lot better.
Yeah, my throat's not sore anymore either.
Like, this might have healing property. Well, organic. It's organic.
You just now realized that.
Huh, so it actually might, like, help you if you're, like, not feeling well.
Which, if you're one of those weirdos that always, like, straight organic stuff, you can drink this.
Oh yeah. Like, you know, it may say like death and stuff like that on it, you know.
Sure, it costs $20 for 18 cups, but I think it's well worth it, honestly.
I mean, yeah, it's actually good quality. I mean, it's easy to, like, spend, like, coffee's already expensive. Like, sure, you might go to Walmart and get, like, great value, like, watered-down coffee.
But that's watered-down. This has, like, straight out of the Keurig, didn't drop any, like, straight
water. Yeah, like, I was straight watching that, not a single drop of water. Like, it was, like, maybe, like, a couple, like 5 seconds from away from starting to drop water, but so it still had a little bit to go for drop water, and of course I did it on medium, so I can probably do it on large and it would have not done.
And these cups are like packed with coffee, like great value. And you open them up and it's only like half full.
Can I say how nice these are as well, because they make it so if you have a normal coffee cup, to make it so you can just peel it open. Where was it? Yeah, look. You can just make it so you can just peel it open, so you can just pour it into a normal coffee
thing. But they also, at Walmart, they also have the, you know, four regular coffee makers.
Yeah. But, yeah, I guess that's it for this video. I guess maybe we need to film another video.
Yeah. We'll see.
I mean, he's here for a couple more hours, so.
Heck, I could be here all day if you need me.
Nah, I wouldn't do that. Anyways, I'll see you in the next video.
Bye.